有趣。This is not going well so far. Tweeting. All right, now look if, see if, the stream's up. TV / future poll. Boom. We'll pop out this chat. Oh, yeah. I'll look at my phone on the stream. Oh, the painting's cricket. That's all right. All right. Let's see. We ready? Ready to do this? Oh, byword's not open. There's byword. Let's quit Twitter. Got a chat window. All right. Window management phase of the stream is over. Okay. So, let's see. Got a new thing that I'm thinking. Got a new idea. It's not like the snowflake method. It's a different way to outline that I think would be really helpful for me. Oh, by the way, so I have a slightly improved setup. I don't have a mic, but I have an external keyboard missing the tilde key. So, let's see. Yeah, guess I can still do tildes. Let's see. Let's practice tildes. Oh, yeah. Oh, totally. Well, that's a... There's the tilde. It's not great. Why is this... It's like the batteries are loose inside of this thing. And I've got an external mouse, too. So... But, see, the downside is I'm further away from the microphone. So maybe, let me know if this is better or worse audio than normal, because I don't think I would enjoy somebody pounding on the keyboard, but at the same time, I kind of mumble. So maybe it's impossible to understand me now, and so this is worse. So just let me know. Because I'm not going to watch it. All right, so... I've been going back and forth on this whole thing of like, is there enough plot in the chapter to make you want to read more? And so I decided I'm going to have a new exciting method. It's called Little and Big Mysteries. So let's see if we have, hey, it didn't give me the weird buffer error. Okay. So these are all good things that, oh, no, that's how to. We need outline. Yeah. Oh, yeah. So, this is, what do we got here? Oh, yeah, one paragraph per sentence of outline. Then I try to do it with like actual plot points because I tend to get really vague when I'm describing in general story. Woohoo! Awesome. Thank you. Jukafa Sole. All of. You know what? Jukafso. Levera and Diable. I'm not gonna comment. This is not Linux. This is Unix, which is underneath every Mac. This is kind of like the command prompt in Windows, but much more powerful and way cooler. Linux is a variant of Unix, kind of. And this is a program called Vim. See, I can quit out of this. Well, no, I'm not gonna quit. I can make a new tab. Here we go. See, like, these are the files in a folder, and you can CD into other folders. Like, oh, that's not a folder, that's a shell script. See, these are my PNGs I made of fake, plot outlines, and then we'll back out, and then but check this out. We got a shell script to make images of these plot outline things that I'm not really doing anything with. But maybe we could do something with little mysteries using dot dot files. That sounds fun. Let's try dot. So let's see, plot. Oh no, characters. Which one has? No, that one doesn't have the arrows. Plot. This has arrows. So I was thinking we could do. What I want is what keeps you going when you're reading a book. Is that there's a big mystery. I mean, it depends on the book, but typically there's like a big mystery that the whole book is about. So you're reading to the end and you're expecting the big mystery that's set up early in the book to be solved at the end. Like, who is Sirius Black? Will he kill me? Nope, turns out he's my dad's best friend and he's trying to protect me. But there's also lots of little mysteries, like who sent me this broom randomly? Stuff like that. And the goal is everything in the book, I think, unless I'm wrong, should have something to do at least with a little mystery. And the little mysteries are what kind of keep you going in between the major reveals for the big mysteries. Does that make sense? Is this a terrible idea? Yuka F.S. Oliveira. Cool. Maybe spell it phonetically, I'd get it. Let's try it. So what I want to do is just, I don't think I'm going to go through the whole book, but at least for the start, I want to make sure that these chapters that I want to be very focused on moon life and painting a picture of suburban moon life, which is kind of a core part of what this book is about at all, don't neglect to give you a hint of the big mystery. And then also, there's always a little mystery that you're dealing with, is my goal. We always have some little mystery that we're either, scene setting is useful for understanding the scenario of this little mystery that we find ourselves in. Scene setting, just for scene setting's sake, I don't want in this book. I want it should tie into a little mystery. If I want to describe something, I better figure out a little mystery that it's solving for me. And maybe those are going to be really mundane mysteries if I think they're interesting enough. But I want to have some sort of thing. I don't know if the dot file is going to work for this. Because every mystery is going to have sort of when the question is asked, well, who is Sirius Black? And then when it's ultimately answered. And little mysteries will often feed into helping solve the big mystery, or there might be little tangents or whatever. Let's just put this at the bottom of the outline. So let's go back in here. Okay. Little and big mysteries. Okay. And I'll just B and L. So big mystery. Who chose Andreas and why? So that's something that's in like the literally the first paragraph of the book. Like, I chose Andreas, I the narrator. So who is the narrator? It's kind of one of the mysteries of this book. And kind of the big mystery, I think. Stuff happens, and throughout the course of this book, Andreas is going to climb the ladder of understanding why all this stuff is happening. She's going to climb the chain of command and ultimately find the source of why things are happening. And I feel like so let's call this BM, big mystery, and then a big answer. Learn how to use Vimple. Big answer is Dev chose Andreas. And another big answer, why Dev chose Andreas. So somewhere in the middle of the book, or maybe the two-thirds of the way into the book, Andreas will learn that Dev chose Andreas. And by the end of the book, of this book one of this upcoming trilogy of sci-fi novels, Andreas will know why. That is, it's not the theme of the book, but this is the big mystery. These are the big answers to that big mystery. Maybe we'll have mid-sized mysteries. Let's try. So, what's very soon in a mid-sized mystery is that where did Jared come from? And so these are going to be really important for me as I write this because if I'm just talking about Jared and I'm not somehow making the reader or Andreas or both curious about where Jared came from, then I'm just talking about Jared. I need to get people hooked on this mid-sized mystery. To make it worth their time. What time is it? 8:50. All right. So, we're going to have a mid-sized answer. Jared is from Mars, by the way. Whenever it looks like I'm doing any outlining, and if you don't want spoilers and you want to wait 3 years for the book to come out, that's you just skip ahead and see if I'm just working on prose again. It's a pro tip. Jared is from Mars. See, and there's going to be lots of little mysteries, probably, that will help flesh this out. Little mysteries with little answers that kind of flesh out the picture of Jared. The big answer is Jared's from Mars. You know, I don't know if these are separate, but maybe they are. Huge spoiler. Never saw it coming. I think if it's more little mysteries. So let's see. Chapter one plot. See, we don't have little mysteries pulling us along. I mean, I guess there's a little mystery. Will they get caught for the cigarette? That's answered in the first chapter. So what other mysteries are carrying us along? We're going to hang out after school. What mysteries are carrying us along in that? Not a lot of mysteries. Like, I mean, it could be maybe just as basic as, like, why are Sarah and Andreas friends? Or what's life like on the moon? But that I need to, if that's going to be the case, then I need to somehow make the reader wonder those things. This is going to be really helpful. I like how it's challenging what I've already written. Maybe we'll go through it from the start again. I would enjoy that. I don't know if anybody else would. I'm really used to starting this project over. How about I think the first chapter is really establishing the character, like moral character of Andreas. Like, if you look at what we're doing, there's the cigarette thing, there's practice, track, there's hanging out after school, like how she responds to that. C see how she interacts with her brother and her mom. And she talks to Skylar before bed. So the medium-sized mystery that chapter one is about is... Who's Andreas? And the mid-sized answer is... And I think that's important to establish in the first chapter anyways. This isn't really asking a lot of me, I don't think. This is kind of what I was already on the track for. So we'll just... So we want to make sure the reader is wondering this. So I think I probably, this big mystery, I think I need to refer to it maybe like this choosing. And I think this choosing will help also prompt, like the reader should be considering, why would I pick Andreas over Sarah or any human? What is it about Sarah that this unknown narrator likes, which helps with the big mystery? What is it with Andreas that this unnamed, which helps with the big mystery, helps with the mid-sized mystery? Cool. That's good. I don't even need this little mystery, really. I mean, that's more incidental. I think these mid-sized mysteries will do most of the work for me because I just got to make sure that that's on the reader's mind every once in a while, and then I can just write whatever I want. All right. That didn't take very long. So let's go back to chapter one. Who chose Andreas? Who is Andreas? Why is I mean, if you think about, like, the opening of Hunger Games is very much about why Katniss is competent to fight in the Hunger Games. You're kind of prepared for her to be competent. And then you question her competency later because she doesn't seem nearly as prepared as some of the other people. But you've got this reason to kind of think something's up, that she's got something special. All right, oh my gosh, this swap files. I need to learn newer than swap file. What, whoa, edit anyways, please, thank you. Okay. Okay, let's just make sure we've got. I picked Andreas. Oh, it doesn't even say chose, it says I picked. Reading J.K. Rowling's new detective novel, the Cormoran Strike series. The way she describes people, she typically says if they're beautiful or ugly. She describes the eyes and the hair. And like the body type sometimes. I'm not a person that notices hair color. Feel like, yeah. Let's see, that's somehow, let's see, that's real far. Okay. Like this. Nice divider, Paul. Oh, yeah, I gotta figure out the class schedule. Don't think she's going to class on this day. Or she's not being written in class this day. First sick period, so I said, how about, I like that about her. Sarah tolerated. See, we're working in our big mystery and our little mystery. Do you like this about Andreas? I don't know. I like it. That's me. Let's turn all that. Let's see this. I like this because it's explaining why nothing was going to be done. It also explains kind of the vibe of how moon people live their life. Should come up with a name for the brain computers. What if I've got a name? I'd zoned out in here. I think the word I was using was augment. I had this word, I don't know. This is the worst word ever. It's also, I think it's college. Augies? For people who are augmented, but I don't like it. What if I keep it generic and say brain augmentations? I like that. This explains why they're both cool, doesn't single out Andreas, but I think it's still feeding into that little mystery. I think that could still be in somebody's head at this point. But I probably may need to remind them again that we picked. These glasses are an old prescription. Does not work great, and I'm too far from the computer. Gotta find another screen setup. So, this one. Step in the school before she reached the turn. From the ground entirely. Both these. paragraph seems a little messy. She won't pay for pool. This I've used from the outlines. Oh, we can put one of our fancy things in. Yeah. What if it's experienced music videos? Just played. All right, we're caught up. It's time to write. I think we're doing good. Got a loop back to cigarette compo. Good evening. Welcome to a quiet stream, but I think very productive one. So, I don't know what this whole mild buzz, fake drunk thing. I feel like it makes them seem a little one note. I think they need to have a conversation. It's just hard for me to write. Oh, sitting and fixing my hair on this one. It's because I don't know, quite know what to do. We gotta go back to the cigarette convo. Whoa. What was the cigarette convo? Didn't do a lot of talk. They said, "This is incredible." That's one thing that was said. They didn't talk about anything. Yeah, they literally didn't talk. What am I thinking? Well, it's about some people on the moon, some high school students on the moon and their adventures. Tough guys. I like this line. I don't like the next line. Really stymied these days, aren't I? Thought these my little mysteries and medium mysteries. Help me a little more. Yeah, I was thinking Sarah would say something like disease. Why would she have books? They live on the moon. Come on, Paul, get together. She pulled out her tablet. There we go. Super futuristic. Tablets. Tablet computers coming soon in the 22nd century. good name for a teacher. For example, Mr. Karkofkerson or something. How about this guy? Let's say your name. It's happening right now. Also, I looked at a book the other day by J.K. Rowling. It has italics in the speech for emphasis, which makes sense. I'm not going to put italics in my non-speech, non-dialogue, but in dialogue, I'll use italics. That sounds like a good compliment. That's a badly written sentence. Bad sentence. Let's write a better version of that sentence. Yeah, I gotta call my parents pretty soon, but another 10 minutes.
Finish this by Christmas.
Oh, yeah. I'm really on pace. Yeah. I don't know where this conversation is going. Look at this, guys. 0 dropped frames. That is a new record. See, making Andreas defend high school education right now is not the way I want to be building her character. Pretty good argument. What would Sarah say to that? Let us look. Let us look at our character descriptions to remind ourselves all about Sarah. Sarah and she fights with her friend on fear and vanity. Be cooler than her best friend. That's still maybe friends. So this is pretty in character for Sarah right now. Andreas is supposed to be bored of the moon. I guess this is good. She's bored. I mean, she plays by the rules. She does her homework at least. terrible. Hawaiian Grace. So Grace is bored, but sort of conformist in some ways, I think. Why would that make the narrator pick her? What is her special twist on being a conformist? The narrator wants somebody willing to utilize power. So she sees an advantage in learning. Oh my gosh. I swear, this swap file is driving me crazy. Really surprised I haven't just totally destroyed my edit yet. So Sarah is probably going to play on the attractiveness. That would be way, like, Sarah could say something like, boys don't like smart girls, but I don't know, that's terrible. I don't think that Sarah believes that. And Rich sounds like a psychopath the way I'm writing here. Like, everything's cold and literal, and she needs to be cool somehow. What does she think? Find out next time. Wow, a lot of writing got done today. Let's see how much we get. We started. Well, it was a lot of dialogue. Basically this. Good job, everybody. Teamwork. But more importantly, we have developed the little and big and medium-sized mysteries method. Just really, really good. All right. Cool. We're gonna peace out. Thanks for everybody watched, and thanks for everybody who didn't watch. Doesn't bother me. Try to do this every day. See how long it lasts.